All right, well, it's a privilege to be here, and I didn't realize until I came up that my life started here at Swedish Hospital. A number of years ago, I was born in Swedish Hospital. So, I feel right at home. And it's good to see you all here, and thank you for the privilege of being allowed to speak and share some perspectives. Valerie has given a little bit of background there. I've been practicing for 30 years and am focused on chronic illnesses now, certified by the American Board of Family Practice and the American Board of Environmental Medicine. And in our practice, we take a little bit different approach. We ask different questions and we look for different answers. Our intake typically is a bit longer, anywhere from 60 to 90 minutes, occasionally more than that, to try to get a good grasp on what is going on with patients because we're looking at other things besides the routine. We have an emphasis on clinical nutrition as well as environmental factors that can contribute to inflammatory processes. Just to summarize what I'll be saying today is I'll be approaching fibromyalgia as one of several multi-system disorders. And my perspective over the past 10 years has been that if we expect medications alone to solve our problems, we're unrealistic. The environmental portion of the emphasis today includes avoidance, nutrition, desensitization, detoxification, and other approaches. Now, in order to get a good handle on this, you have to recognize there's more than one paradigm to healthcare, and there's a new paradigm I'll be talking about, which you may be familiar with, but at least which is not the one you typically encounter. The new paradigm is more than simply taking the patient interview, doing lab tests and history and so on, and trying to connect a diagnostic label with a medication. In the new paradigm, we consider that the fact that there are wide genetic variations from one patient to the next. Not everybody's the same, and so one size does not fit all. There are environmental stressors out there, which we'll talk more about later. A nutritional status is important because our ability to respond to the environment through our nervous system, our endocrine system, our immune system, depends upon our nutritional status. Sensitizations can be present. Valerie was alluding to something I'll get to later there. And then the detoxification capacity of the patient, our ability to clear our internal environment and make it cleaner, can vary from person to person. The new paradigm is not linear. Linear medicine refers to someone coming, let's say, with strep throat. Let's say you were exposed to strep throat a few days ago. You now have pain, redness, white spots, tender glands, temperature 101. You go to the doctor, he looks and sees those things, does a strep test, says you've got a positive strep test, gives you penicillin, 24 hours you feel better, 10 days later you're through with the process. That's linear medicine, one variable typically moving through time. The new paradigm is organic, multifactorial, multisystemic, and clearly not linear. So it has to be approached differently if we hope to find solutions. Well, what's fibromyalgia? You folks can tell me. I hurt all over. I don't sleep well. I'm always tired. I don't feel well, and I can't always explain it. Sometimes I'll have people come in, and they'll lose words. They're trying to say something, and they just can't explain it, and that happens. I go to my doctor. He pushes my tender points. He makes me hurt, and then suggests it's all in my head. That leaves me discouraged and hopeless. Well, let me just share a little bit in more detail how I got involved in the environmental approach, or what we call environmental approach. For 18 years, I worked as a family physician, doing the standard sort of things as I've been taught. I had a good medical school here in Seattle, University of Washington. I did what I was instructed in and was helpful in many ways there. And I thought that was all that had to be done. Then something happened. I became sick. Well, there's nothing like having a problem yourself to get a little wake up there. And it was quite a wake-up for me because I had migraine headaches that kept coming back. I had nosebleeds that would last 2 hours after the packing was in. I had kidney stones that kept returning. And I had endless, endless years of sinus, nasal, and lung infections, for which I mistakenly took antibiotics too much. And I went to many doctors, 12 different doctors in the Everett, Seattle area here, and nobody had an answer. No one could tell me why one of the things was happening or why all four things were happening at the same time. I was given medications, and the medications made me sicker. That got my attention, and I finally found a doctor who practiced what we call environmental medicine, multi-system approach and found substantial healing. In the process of being a patient and being treated and getting better, and then spending the three-year program with the Academy of Environmental Medicine that trains in the type of work that I do now, I learned a number of things, and I'll go through these. And I don't know how many of you are patients, how many have also healthcare interests, nurses, doctors, and so on. I'll just give you some of the things that I came across. First of all, I realized that medications can't fix everything. I realized also that non-pharmacological interventions could be quite helpful. I became aware of the fact that of the patients I saw that I assumed were well-nourished, oftentimes were not. I learned that many health problems are not linear. We talked about that. And I also learned that normal does not mean healthy, right, or good. Oftentimes you get your lab tests back and they say, well, you're normal. Oh, nice. And so the next point there are limits to the bell-shaped curve. If you remember statistics, we talk about this bell-shaped curve. It's a way of trying to figure out what's true in life. And so we look at the averages. What do most people have? And if 95% of people have a potassium between 3.5 and 5.0, we say that's normal. That usually works pretty good for potassium. But other things, that bell-shaped curve, there's limits to what that means. I learned also that environmental stressors can affect health, and we'll outline what those stressors might be later. There's an image of a barrel, and I'll talk more about that also later, but that helps us understand something called the total load. Became aware of the fact that we have to consider what's loading up your immune system. What is the total load? I learned that sensitive patients can get worse on standard allergy shots. I had been on those and was going down the tube with them, and that had to do with some of the preservatives in it and had to do with the intensity of the shot. I learned that the body is not homogeneous. If I take a blood sample from the left arm for ferritin, the iron reserve, I can't assume that the result I get tells me about iron in all parts of the body. There may be spots that it's not up to snuff. I learned that a normal B12 level does not always mean normal functional types, appropriate functional amount of B12. There's actually five forms of B12, and I can have a blood level that says I'm normal again, but from a functional point of view, I have to do other tests to see if I've got enough on board. I learned that some people think if there's not a drug to fix a health problem, it means the condition does not exist, but the opposite is true. If we don't have a drug to fix it, it does not mean it does not exist. Linear thought is limited. Complexity requires a comprehensive, integrative approach. Maladaptation clouds understanding symptoms. Maladaptation is something that I was not aware of until I got into environmental medicine. And this means that if a patient is overloaded, and you could think about it psychologically, but usually we think about it physically, like a person living in a moldy home or working in an environment with a lot of chemical exposure, whether it be pesticides or solvents or other types of things like that, the system can be overburdened. And initially we can adapt to that burden, but at some point in time it gets to be too much to it. And if we try to examine the patient, talk to them, and figure out what's going on, things don't make sense because they're in this maladapted state. The little riddle that was given by Valerie here recently, just a few minutes ago here, as to why the allergy testing would not show the answer had to do with this concept. And I believe what we were talking about, there's the individual who is living in an area, again, where there's mold. You do skin testing, and the skin doesn't respond. You come back 6 months later, once they're out of the moldy environment, and check them, and now it'll start to talk. I learned that inborn errors of metabolism are more common than I was taught. There was about 20 or 25 when I was in medical school in the 70s, and it's into the thousands now, these little tiny bits, tiny changes in the way our chemistry is made up. People aren't all the same.